This is what I call, or what the industry refers to as a test out procedure. So after any major work is done to a building, especially if there's air sealing that has occurred, it's very important that the energy auditor return and do another round of blower door testing to calculate the ventilation requirements for the building, and to do combustion safety testing to make sure that with the new, better air sealed building envelope, that there are no issues with combustible gas leaks, carbon monoxide levels in combustion appliances, and any worst case depressurization issues, which is to say, trying to figure out if it's possible that some backdrafting may occur when wood stoves, boilers, anything that is a natural draft appliance is used. So again, this is sort of the wrap-up. The initial energy audit identifies the issues with the building, the work fixes those issues, and the test-out procedure is designed to make sure that the work was done properly and that the house is left in a safe condition. My blower door is set up now. I'm just going to go around the house, make sure all the windows are closed and locked, damper shut on the wood stove, make sure the boiler is off so it doesn't come on during the blower door testing, and right away we'll find out how much air sealing we achieved in this house because I can compare the blower door number we get today with the blower door number I did on the initial energy audit. One of the improvements we made on this building was to insulate the knee wall spaces, which you can see an access door right here. I'm going to head into that knee wall space right now so you get a sense of what it looks like after a finished slope ceiling or rafter bay has had dense pack silos installed. Okay, we are in the knee wall space here now, and you can see this insul web netting, this netting which retains the cellulose, and behind that is the dense pack cellulose. If it's properly installed, it should feel like a firm mattress, which it does. This is a really good job. The guys have done an excellent job here. I'm pleased to see this. You can also see at the very end there's a small gable and wall cavity we have to treat in these knee wall spaces, these side attics, to complete the thermal boundary. So I'm pleased with what I'm seeing here. Of course, the proof will be in the pudding when we get the new blower door number. I have the house all set up and ready to go for the blower door testing, so I'm going to pull my plate off the front here and fire this door up so we can see what our air leak reduction was. Here we go. Try to depressurize to negative 50 pascals, which I'm sure will be no problem in this house. Okay, so I'm not getting enough air through that fan because the building is so well air sealed now that I have to put in a smaller ring. Let's see what that does. I'm gonna update my configuration. Okay, here we go. All right, now we're getting plenty of air through that fan. I'm going to bring this up to the negative 50 pascals that we want for accurate measurements. Now I'm going to have it average all of the points that it's taking over the next few seconds. It should level out, and when it does, I can compare it to the original blower door number. The original blower door number was 3,936 cubic feet per minute at 50 pascals. Right now we're at 2,109 CFM50. That is a huge reduction in airflow to this building. I am doing a round of worst case testing right now to the boiler and wood stove, or what we call the combustion appliance zones. Simply put, what I'm doing is measuring the pressure difference inside and outside the building under normal conditions, and then I am turning on all of the exhaust appliances in the building, which include the dryer, bathroom exhaust fans, range hoods, sometimes central vacuuming. All of these appliances take indoor air and exhaust it out of the building, which potentially deprives the combustion appliances of necessary combustion air. So I have to measure how much negative pressure is created when all of these fans are on to determine if there is a likelihood of backdrafting. And if there is, there are steps we can take to make sure that that does not occur and that those combustion appliances get enough combustion air.
I have the worst case conditions set up right now. My preliminary pressure readings indicated that there may be some issues with spillage or backdrafting with the boiler and wood stove. Now, with the worst case conditions underway, I'm going to actually start up this combustion appliance and see if it does in fact spill flue gases during operation. So here we go. Right now, since there's no barometric draft controller, I'm just seeing that smoke is being introduced into the blower or burner, and right now it is definitely pulling air in, so it passes what we call the spillage test.
So the last thing I have to do here is a combustible gas leak test. Just to make sure there's no propane leaks in the building. We're going to test all the fittings associated with different appliances in the building. And let's see, what did you miss? I measured the second story bathroom exhaust fan, which was a new bathroom exhaust fan install as part of the work, to see how much we can depend upon that. And it came out at 56 cubic feet a minute. We want to see a minimum of 50 cubic feet a minute, so that's good. We can depend upon that new bathroom exhaust fan to get water vapor out of the bathroom where it's made, and also potentially to provide some whole house ventilation should the need arise. So I'm quite impressed with the job that our guys did here. We achieved 46% leak space reduction, which is, you know, cutting airflow in a building by half is pretty impressive. And this building didn't start off wicked leaky in the first place, so these folks have already reported that they see an improvement in comfort. They feel that already. I'm sure that they're also going to be pleased when they get their fuel oil bill after this winter and are able to compare it to past winters. So this is another job well done. Happy customers, safe, comfortable, efficient home. I suspect we'll probably be back to do some more insulation in the basement as a second phase, maybe in the garage, but for now, we have insulated all of the attic spaces, the flat ceilings, the finished slope ceilings, the knee wall spaces, so the entire cap of this building is now fairly well air sealed and insulated. So now it's just a matter of working the bottom, and it will be a truly energy efficient home.